Hi all, welcome to our YouTube channel. So we are back again with the most important questions for Prelim 2020, and the word of the day is hard work. So moving on to the first question for the day. Consider the following statement. First, non-cooperation movement. Second, first hunger strike. Third, first mass strike. Fourth, first civil disobedience movement. Arrange the following in the correct sequence. A, 1, 2, 3, 4. B, 4, 1, 2, 3. C, 2341, D, 3412. So here the correct answer is B, 4123. Now the reason being, let's start with the first one. So the Champaran Satyagraha, which is popularly known as the first civil disobedient movement, was held on April 1917. Then we have the first non-cooperation movement, also called as the Khera Satyagraha, that is March 1918. Then we have the first hunger strike, that is the Ahmedabad mill strike, March 1918. And lastly, we have the first mass strike against the Rowlatt Act on March 1919. Alright, so moving on to the next question. Which of the following state in India is known for having all three species of crocodile, namely gharial, marsh crocodile, saltwater crocodile? A, Andhra Pradesh. B, Chhattisgarh. C, Orissa. D, Maharashtra. So here the correct answer is C, Orissa. Also, Orissa has taken a lot of initiative in this area in order to protect gharial, which is also under the critically endangered list of the IUCN. Alright, so the correct answer here is C, Orissa. Moving on to the next question. Shillong Declaration, which was in news recently, is related to what? A, we have a joint agreement between Bhutan and India to tackle insurgency issue. Then we have B, it is a government policy which is related to e-governance. C, none of the above. D, a joint initiative among ASEAN members to fight against terrorism. Now here the correct answer is B, it is a government policy which is related to e-governance. Alright, so moving on to the next question. Consider the following statements with reference to two Indian innovations of the Indian Parliament. First statement, the zero hour is not mentioned in the rule of procedure. Second statement, calling attention motion is mentioned in the rule of procedure. Third statement, zero hour helps the member of parliament to raise matters without any prior notice. Fourth statement, calling attention motion draws the attention of ministers to seek an authoritative statement on matters of public importance. Now here, the correct answer is D, all of the above. Alright, so moving on to the next question. The first guidelines on self-care intervention for health has been launched by which of the following organization? A, UNICEF. B, World Health Organization. C, Pan American Health Organization. D, International Organization for Migration. E, Center for Disease Control and Welfare. So here the correct answer is B, World Health Organization. Moving on to the next question. Consider the following statement with reference to Gandhara and Mathura School of Art. First statement, the Gandhara and Mathura School of Art has an element of Greek influence. Second statement, during the Kushana rule, the Mathura School of Art prospered in India, especially under Kanishka's rule. Third statement, the stone used in Mathura School of Art was in red sandstone. So the correct answer here is C3 only. Now the reason being is that Gandhara School of Art showed elements of Greek culture and influence, whereas the Mathura School of Art was purely a indigenous initiative, and also it had no foreign influence in it whatsoever. Now the second statement is wrong, the reason being it is supposed to be the Gandhara School of Art and not the Mathura School of Art. Alright, moving on to the next question. Which of the following statements with respect to Government of India Act 1935 are true? It is provided for the establishment of Reserve Bank of India to control the currency and credit of the country. Second statement, it abolished dyarchy in the province and introduced provincial autonomy. Third statement, this act introduced direct elections in India for the first time. Fourth statement, the act introduced dyarchy at the center. A, all of the above, B, 2 and 3 only, C, 1 and 4 only, D, 3 only. Now, the correct answer here is A, all of the above. Alright, moving on to the next question. Select the correct statement about the Laffer curve using the quotes given below. This is a curve which supposes that for a given economy, there is an optimum income tax level to maximize tax revenue. Second statement, if the income tax level is set below this level, then raising taxes will increase tax revenues. Third statement, if the income tax level is set above this level, then lowering tax will increase tax revenue. Correct the quote. Now A, 1 and 2 only, B, 2 and 3 only, C, 1 and 3 only, D, all of the above. Now here the correct answer is D, all of the above. Now all the statements are actually correct, and the term Laffer curve was coined by an American economist, Arthur Laffer. Moving on to the next question. Consider the following. Boom. Business activity at high level with an increase in income, output and employment. B. Recession. A gradual fall of income, output, employment with business activity at low. C. Depression. A unprecedented level of employment with drastic income and output as well. Recovery. The fourth statement. A steady rise in general level of prices, income, output and employment. Select the correct code. A. 1, 2, 3, 4. B. 1, 2, 3 only. C. 2, 3, 4 only. D. 3 and 4 only. So here the correct answer is A. 1, 2, 3, 4. So all the statements here are correct. Alright. Moving on to the last question for the day. Aral Sea is an endorheic lake lying between which two countries? A. Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan. B. Kazakhstan and Turkmenistan. C. Kazakhstan and Azerbaijan. D. Kazakhstan and Turkey. So here the correct answer is Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan. So that's it for the day. And for more information on our various courses, please visit our website www.aschars.com. And for more such daily videos, please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.